Because you can have a girl who has a humongous elephant booty, but it's like shaped all weirdly. It just looks nasty. Like, nah, I'm good.
They say birds of a feather flock together. And I guess that also applies to dodo birds, because over the years, there have been more crack brain trends than flavors of Ben and Jerry's ice cream, bro. It's like a disease of lunacy that spread over the internet quicker than some dollar store lotion or something. Some of these heedless activities I've seen on the internet over the past couple years has really made me think that Charles Darwin's theory of evolution was inscribed backwards. I'm 100% certain without a shadow of a doubt that most transitive people—
You see?
Theory of evolution was inscribed backwards.
Bro, this trend? I'm 100%— This trend where people were licking ice cream?
Certain without—
When people were licking ice cream, that trend pissed me off, bro. This trend pissed me off when people were licking ice cream. It wasn't even like I was an ice cream enthusiast. Like, I like ice cream like the next guy, but it's the fact that people were licking it, putting the lid back on, and then putting it back in the freezer. Like, why was that even a trend? Why did people do that, bro? Oh my gosh, that was so disgusting. And it got to the point where, like, stores started locking up their ice creams. That way people couldn't do it because the trend got so bad. It got so bad that they had to start locking up their ice cream, man. I hope everyone who did this trend got arrested. I hope so, bro.
Percent certain without a shadow of a doubt that most transitive people conducting the most rancorous ventures known to man. So today, we'll be discussing some of the most unadorned and imbecilic trends that have ever transpired on the internet, as well as the complications and hindrances that they cause.
Let's get
Comment
it.
Down below the stupid ass crate challenge.
This challenge the crate
is
challenge.
A definition to fuck around and find out.
Bro, anybody so many backs.
Doing this shit, bro. Young people, old people, aunties, uncles, senior citizens.
Hey, you want to know the worst part about the crate challenges? If you ever watch the crate challenge video or like a compilation of them, you notice a slight little trend. It's usually black people doing it, bro. I don't know why the crate challenge was some of the, it did detrimental damage to the black community, bro. Almost as bad as crack did to the black community, bro. Oh my gosh, I remember seeing those crate challenge videos. Niggas were snapping their spine in half, Mortal Kombat, fatality, just to get a couple of clicks on the internet. Now, I am a YouTuber, I understand how irresistible, how succulent getting views on the internet is. But nigga, are you getting paid off of it? You probably aren't. You probably just like created an account just to post that video, just to get the views. I'm getting paid off of it. So if I do something stupid or cringe, at least I'm counting them dollar bills, man. But y'all, not y'all, the people watching, or some of y'all watching, the people doing the crate challenge, like, why are you trying to send yourself to the ER just for some views, bro? Crazy.
The dumbassery was peaking at immeasurable heights. Seriously, bro, you had some of the most uncoordinated people
I've
ever seen in my life try to ascend this tower of crate. And they would be surprised when they would fall.
Did you really think you were gonna make it? Look at you.
And they would be surprised when they would fall and crash harder than the economy in 2007. And then the people watching got the nerve to say, "Oh, you were so close." My nigga, close to what? The pearly gates? Not to be mentioned, they used to be shaking like an iron.
Legs shaking, bro.
And I couldn't help but cringe every time I would see these niggas fold themselves like origami. The poses that these motherfuckers were ending up in would make a yoga instructor jealous. Really worth their 15 seconds of fame?
Fortunately, it's never worth it.
Afterlife, but there were people left paralyzed. I know the nurses and doctors were working seconds of fame.
No way.
Fortunately, nobody was sent to the afterlife, but there were people.
Upon falling on the ground, the lady fainted, and the people recording had to stop the content they had created. They then rushed towards her. However, information that hits the internet confirms that the lady has been paralyzed for life following a broken spinal cord. Can you imagine never being able to use your legs just because you wanted 30 seconds of fame? Is it worth it? Is it worth it, guys? I'm so glad this trend, that challenge, the crate challenge, I'm so glad it's over, bro. You are paralyzed for life for 30 seconds of fame. I bet you feel like the biggest idiot in the world. It's not worth it.
People left paralyzed. I know the nurses and doctors were working overtime to tend to these niggas, bro. But I have one question for the class. Where the hell is everybody getting these crates from? They had to be hitting
Facts?
To no end, bro. Or they're abandoned by the government. I'm not really sure.
But I don't even know if I can find one crate.
These ghetto ass Olympics anyway. Like, it doesn't even seem fun or congenial in any way, shape, or form. This clip was pretty funny, though.
What's wrong, okay?
When I came down.
Now we gotta talk about plastic surgery. The fact that this phenomenon plastic has surgery. Occurred enough for me to call us a trend is vexing enough. Now, if you've seen this video, then you're already informed about how I feel about these blithering BBL buffoons. I've never been able to decipher why people feel BBL the need to mutilate their bodies. Buffoons. I've seen some of the most disfigured and disproportionate entities to ever grace the globe. They in this bitch looking like rejected bug life characters, bro. I'm talking straight bedrock booty. Why can't people just be happy with the bodies they were blessed with instead of turning themselves into a low-budget Kick Buttowski? And it'd be one thing if you weren't really able to tell they got surgery, but most of the people who go under the knife end up...
It's just some nasty-ass ant booties, bro.
...botching themselves completely. And I hope I'm not the only person who finds...
Like, do you find this attractive, guys? Look at this. Look at this right here. Is that attractive to you? You can literally place your water bottle, whatever beverage you're drinking, and place it on her derriere, bro. That is a shelf. That's too big. It's too big. That is way too much ass, bro. And it doesn't even look good. Hey, I'm a firm believer in, of course, like, size matters, bro. For both men and women. But we're talking about women right now. Of course, size matters. You know, the size of the nyash. If you don't know what nyash means, it essentially means booty, butt, cheeks. Booty, butt, cheeks. Nyash. I'm going to say that a lot now. But essentially, I'm a firm believer in shape means more or matters more than the actual size. Because you can have a girl who has a humongous elephant booty, but it's like shaped all weirdly. It just looks nasty. Like, nah, I'm good. But when it's like nice and perky and shaped perfectly, like, bro, mwah, chef's kiss. The shape trumps the size. But size does matter. You know what I'm saying?
Why is these prosthetic pampers repulsive anyway? I couldn't imagine blowing a couch tuition just to look like a fucking wisdom tooth. I'd rather have my baby built like a telephone poles in a science experiment gone wrong. Who's getting turned on by shit like this, bro? Actually, I'll take that back because I've encountered some niggas who would fuck a bed bug if I gave them the chance. And it doesn't stop with the BBLs because motherfuckers are turning their faces into Picasso paintings and shit.
Ah, the lips.
Y'all remember this, but a couple years back, there was a guy who got a magnitude of work done to his face and claimed that he was transracial and identifies as a Korean man. Now, last time I checked, I'm pretty sure I'm not Korean, but if I had to take a shot in the dark, I'd probably say a couple surgeries to make your eyes slimmer doesn't exactly make the cut. But if you're Korean and watching this video, let me know. But apparently he also wants to get a different type of surgery to become 100% Korean. Yeah, I'm about to go gouge my eyes out with a rusty spoon. And then there was that entire Dr. Kim situation where he was absolutely morphing niggas' faces and turning them into Muppets. And I'm pretty sure I already go into convoluted detail about lip fillers and face reductions and the extreme liposuction, walking around looking like Candy Wife from Flapjack. But at the end of the day, if this is what you want for yourself, then by Jove, go right ahead. And hey, if you don't want to take my word for it, just listen to Kylie Jenner. She's happy with the way God created her. It's not like she's got so much class in her body.
I'm happy with the way God created me. Head ass, Kylie Jenner. But I will say though, Kylie Jenner, her surgeon was in his back. She's pretty. Kylie Jenner is pretty. I will say though, like, the lips can be a little bit smaller, but she is definitely pretty. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you. If a chick who looked like Kylie Jenner walked up to me, even though I know that it is plastic surgery, fillers, whatever, she's pretty, guys. I'm sorry, she is pretty. I'm tapping that. I'm sorry, bro. I'm not even sorry. Why am I apologizing? Like, she's undeniably pretty. A lot of niggas will hit that.
Kylie Jenner. She's happy with the way God created her. It's not like she's got so much plastic in her body that she's gonna need to be recycled when she passes away. Now we gotta talk about the gallon smashing trend. Now in the past, I've already
gallon smashing.
My on working
is that where you grab a gallon of milk
that it caused
and just slam it on the floor?
Someone came in and just obliterated some milk cartons for.
I remember that.
I gotta clean it up. If you're one of the people that found these videos comical, I know you're actively munching on crayons as we speak. I remember this was a thing back when Vine was still around, but for some reason, it came
Vine.
Back like the Terminator or something.
That's where I got my start.
Going viral to begin with. Oh, look at me! I pretend to fall and throw my milk comically high in the air, little. And then they'd be taking advantage of the nice people who actually believe that they fell and try to help them up. Is this even classified as a prank? Because last time that I checked, pranks were supposed to result in both respective parties having a grand old time. Nowadays, it's just people going out in public and doing.
If I was an employee at that store and you did some shit like this, bro, I would have to beat your ass, bro. I'm sorry. That is the day I'm turning in my employee badge because I'm whooping ass, man. I'm not cleaning that, bro. Who raised y'all?
Shit like this. Plus, buying groceries costs more than a fucking mortgage at this point, so this is just ignorant, bro. Now we gotta
talk
about
when
people were licking ice cream. And no, I'm not talking about when the fake ass NPCs were licking imaginary ice cream, talking about ice cream.
Thanks for the ice cream.
Talking about when niggas were cracking ice cream cartons open like a Legend of Zelda chest and dragging their dusty ass
licking it
over
and
the surface
putting
of
it
ice
back.
Cream like they're trying to roll the fattest backwood, bro. Similar to our last talking point, this once again comprised of people recording themselves being absolutely gormless inside grocery stores. I really think this is what prompted the COVID-19 pandemic to start in the first place.
Low-key.
This project should have been expunged from the globe.
Low-key.
And this really grinds my gears because if you know me, you know I love ice cream more than Joe Biden does. Like, imagine trying to get some scrumptious and delectable ice cream after a hard day's work. To you, that should place
a nigga just licked it or some shit, bro.
This is why I reach as far as I can to the back when shopping for food. Mm-hmm. I'll be honest, if you're buying food that isn't sealed in any fashion, you're a bold individual. But speaking of licks, now we gotta talk about devious licks. Now, y'all know I hate school as much as the next man, but the thought of plundering a soap dispenser or anything devious.
Funny story is,
now y'all know
this video. If you ever seen this video, it's like a dude crashing out in like a college library. This was actually filmed at the TCC where I used to go to. And I didn't personally know the guy who filmed this video, but I knew of him.
I hate school as much as the next man, but the thought of plundering a soap dispenser or anything from school has never crossed my mind. These videos I was seeing on the internet were absolutely preposterous, bro. Since when did it become cool to commit crimes? Luckily, this trend never really caught wind in my school, except for the fact that niggas were nabbing soap dispensers like they were free samples.
I never
Costco.
Seen this
and
trend.
Since our school didn't believe in the well-being and prosperity of their students, they never replaced them. But like I said earlier, the videos I was seeing were nothing short of nefarious. Niggas were stealing desks, whiteboards, fire alarms, stall doors, entire toilets. It was getting ridiculous.
That was
bro.
A trend.
What actually bamboozled me was the fact that niggas were still dropping deuces broad day with no regard. These niggas had no shame, but the people destroying the bathroom were looking like Mr. Krabs and SpongeBob when they was leaving that hotel. I was questioning how they were even getting access to such items, let alone leaving the school with them. Like, how do you leave the school with an entire water fountain in your hands? But you know these niggas were malevolent when TikTok themselves wiped the entire challenge from their app like some Windex.
Thank
that
you.
Still didn't stop these maniacal motherfuckers from destroying their schools bit by bit like a fucking game of Jenga. Now we gotta talk about gender reveal parties. Now look, don't get me wrong, the idea and concept of a gender reveal party is totally
cool.
Fine. If y'all want another excuse to get together and eat cake like the big blubber
exactly.
back-ass
it's
individuals
cool.
you are, then be my guest. And for the most part, gender reveal parties are pretty harmless.
It's when you do the most.
Several years, these parties have been more dramatic than a high school play. Like, these parties really be looking like fake-ass WWE entrances, bro. Now, for this next exercise, I want you to watch the video that will transpire on the screen.
All right, let's watch it. Okay. When's the... Oh, my goodness gracious, bro. You could have just cut into a cake and see if it was pink or blue. Golly. They doing gender reveal parties like this nowadays? I must be going to the wrong gender reveal parties. The thing about this is like, that's not even anything too bad because like, you know, it's in the comfort of their own backyard or whatever venue they're doing it at. And they're celebrating bringing life into the world. So compared to the other challenges slash trends that were on this list, this one ain't even too bad, man. It's just like extra, you know, it's just a little bit extra, but you know, you can go ahead and be a little extra if you are expecting parent, you know?
Is that not insane? Now, I'm sure some of you have probably come to the conclusion that I'm just hating. But when you got JJ the jet plane tooting out blue smoke, polluting all the air within a 20-mile radius, it's
they
a little
niggas flying planes for gender reveals.
The Taco Bell toilet. But now we gotta worry about bushfires and random ass explosions. But the most perturbing thing about these gender reveals videos is when the father is clearly pissed off that they're having a daughter. I understand that most
you gotta
of the time
hide that reaction.
Son and the mother wants to have a daughter. But to be throwing a temper tantrum when you find that you're having a daughter is vacuous. Like, imagine being the daughter of one of these motherfuckers and seeing the video of your dad falling to his knees like Walter White. That's fucked up, bro. Now we gotta talk about the cinnamon challenge. Now this is a little
okay,
bit of a throwback.
That's a throwback.
If you were on the internet at the time, you remember that this challenge had the internet in a bigger chokehold than Darth Vader.
Throwback.
Once again, these videos were comprised of people damn near offing themselves on camera. Now this challenge wasn't as serious because the individual could just grab some water and save themselves from affliction and anguish. And the people that were performing this challenge used to be talking hella shit just for them to shit the bed like Amber Heard, bro. And plus, I learned that cinnamon comes from tree bark, so niggas were pretty much ingesting spicy sawdust. Now we gotta talk about
spicy
veneers.
Sawdust.
Now this is
veneers?
A trend that's suddenly taken the world by storm, and that's predominantly due to Atlanta pioneering the occupation of a veneer technician. Now what is a veneer technician, you may ask? What
a veneer technician is a girl who created an Instagram account, watched a couple of videos, and now she knows how to do veneers, bro. That's literally what a veneer technician is, man. If you want to get veneers, go to a dentist. Don't go to veneers by V on Instagram, bro. No, come on.
Apparently niggas are taking this Team Umi
Zumi
ass
looking like some goofy ass
teeth to start ruining teeth.
Oh my
right.
gosh.
No joke, these motherfuckers are setting up shop in their fucking basement and just
looking like bathroom tiles
into people's mouths, bro. And then they got the nerve to hand out this deceitful ass diploma that's worth about as much as a slap in the face.
My shiny teeth in me.
Principal Brown's diploma was painted to his damn wall. It takes years to become a dentist, let alone a dentist who can distribute veneers. But nah, let me hit up my homegirl Destiny to get acrylic paint on my teeth. Now, in my humble opinion, veneers are already grotesque as hell. Like, why would I pay an arm and a leg just to look like Dr. Bender? I know it takes every particle of your being to try try and close your mouth with them big ass piano keys in there, bro. But if I ever were to get veneers, I'm going to an actual professional. Not no motherfucker who clicks I'm not a robot on their MacBook.
Because some veneers can actually look decent, you know?
And you can always tell when a motherfucker got these dominoes in their
mouth. They're way too white.
Blindingly white and all the same shape. Because breaking news, we have different teeth for different purposes. But these baddie individuals
just have straight
breaks lining their gums. Moral of the story, get some Crest 3D white strips or just simply start brushing your funky ass teeth. Now we gotta talk about Stanley Cups. Now, for the longest time,
this was the only Stanley Cup
that I was aware of.
But white girls
also call Stanley Cups, and they drive people crazy.
Love Stanley Cups. You got motherfuckers
collecting these bitches like Sonic rings, bro. Isn't the whole point of these cups to be reusable? But yet, you've got one for every calendar day. It's really sad to see how consumerism continues to beat y'all asses day in and day out. There are people fighting over these cups like some ducks for some bread. It's literally just the Hydro Flask epidemic all over again. Now we gotta talk about all these stupid ass tattoos people are getting. We've all seen the neck tattoos and face tattoos that have accumulated.
Unlimited throat.
Specifically, the limitless.
Limitless, yeah.
I've heard of Hall of Fame limitless names. The Hall of Fame. This throat is one for the books. I don't know what type of dignified behavior has gotten these niggas, but I pray to God that this man is never sent to prison, because if them inmates get one glance at that neck, he's gonna need a lifetime supply of ibuprofen. And most of the people that be out here getting face tattoos be looking like them fucking doodle bears from the mid-90s. And is it just me?
What did y'all say? SoundCloud is one who started this?
Unveiled every 10 to 12 business days. Seriously, bro, the last time I seen this many predators was at my local zoo.
Alright, go ahead and comment which one was the dumbest that we seen on this list. I'll say the worst, no, not even the dumbest, the worst was the ice cream one. That pissed me off so much, bro. Cause like I said, I like ice cream as much as the next guy. But people licking ice cream and putting it back, and you know they do not brush their tongue. You know they do not brush their tongue. So all that salmonella, all that nasty gook that was on their tongue is now in the ice cream that you're currently eating.